I want to start by thanking Chancellor Scholz for his welcome and congratulate him on a successful summit. The G7 represents not only many of Canada's closest allies, but our closest friends. In the last 3 days, I had the chance to speak with all the leaders of the G7 and many other leaders, including the presidents of Senegal, South Africa, Indonesia, and Argentina, and the Prime Minister of India. Durant le sommet, on a parlé de plusieurs enjeux comme l'importance de défendre la démocratie, l'augmentation du coût de la vie, la sécurité alimentaire, les changements climatiques, les échanges commerciaux et la création de bons emplois pour la classe moyenne. Évidemment, on a aussi discuté de la guerre illégale de la Russie en Ukraine. Whether it's rising food and fuel prices or supply chain issues, the impacts of Russia's illegal invasion are felt in G7 countries and around the world. And the human cost in Ukraine is tragic. During the summit, my G7 colleagues and I had a virtual meeting with President Zelensky, and I also spoke with him on the phone directly. On reste déterminé à soutenir l'Ukraine alors qu'elle défend courageusement sa souveraineté et son intégrité territoriale. Et on appuie la décision du Conseil européen d'accorder le statut de candidat à l'Ukraine et à la Moldavie. Le Canada va continuer de défendre la démocratie et le droit des Ukrainiens à choisir leur propre avenir. To continue supporting Ukraine, Canada will provide a loan of $200 million to the Ukrainian government to help meet its urgent liquidity needs. We'll also invest over $150 million in new humanitarian development and peace security support. This will include agricultural solutions like grain storage units. In Canada, our farmers typically face big challenges and have been proven to be inventive and creative, so we'll bring this expertise to Ukraine to help as much as we can. Il faut s'attaquer à l'insécurité alimentaire causée par le président Poutine dans le monde, en particulier dans les pays du Sud. Au cours du sommet, on a uni nos efforts pour fournir une aide supplémentaire de 4,5 milliards de dollars américains afin de protéger les personnes les plus vulnérables contre la faim et la malnutrition. Ce montant inclut la somme de 250 millions de dollars canadiens qu'on a annoncé la semaine dernière. On Sunday, for the first time in 3 weeks, Russian missiles hit Kyiv again. And yesterday, a Russian missile hit a shopping mall in Kremenchuk. We condemn these attacks and our hearts go out to the victims and their loved ones. It's important that the world doesn't lose its attention and focus over what's happening in Ukraine. We must and we will remain committed until Ukraine and democracy prevail. Putin and those responsible for these atrocities must be held accountable. Yesterday, Canada imposed new sanctions on over 80 individuals and entities linked to the illegal invasion. And in coordination with the US, the UK and Japan, will impose a ban on the import of certain gold goods from Russia. This will further isolate them from the international financial system. We know that Putin continues to use lies to justify his invasion. Together, we need to counter the Kremlin's disinformation. That's why Canada will soon introduce sanctions against state-sponsored disinformation and propaganda agents and entities controlled by senior Russian officials. En plus de la guerre de la Russie en Ukraine, notre monde est confronté à plusieurs défis. Au cours du sommet, on a pris des mesures importantes pour accélérer les progrès dans la lutte contre les changements climatiques. Le Canada va continuer d'être un leader dans les efforts pour assurer la qualité de l'air, pour créer de bons emplois et pour bâtir un avenir plus résilient. The G7 recognizes the need to do more to support developing countries in their efforts to transition to clean economies, narrow their infrastructure gap, and create jobs and prosperity. Together, we discuss the importance of mobilizing all possible resources to these ends, picking up on the work Prime Minister Motley of Barbados and I are doing as co-chairs of the Sustainable Development Goals Advocates Group. We're united and we're resolved. Our work together continues to make life more affordable for people, to grow the middle class, to fight climate change and build resilient economies, and to create opportunities for businesses and entrepreneurs. I want to thank Chancellor Scholz once again for hosting the summit here in Germany, and I look forward to welcoming him to Canada this coming August. Merci beaucoup tout le monde.